Hi and welcome to Creating a Mouse Collage. We were very inspired by Leo Lionni's book, Frederick, so we decided to do our own. All right, so I've got a really special helper. What's your name?
Lucy.
All right, so Lucy and I are going to do this first. Now, we're going to start on a skill that's really hard for kids. It's this ripping, kind of the pincher fingers. So Lucy, can you do your pincher fingers a little bit? Can you show kiddos? Look at this. Okay, and she's on it. Now, some kids struggle with this, so we just rip a little bit off each side.
And if it gets a little bit in, I just tear it back out.
I love that. That's the solution. Yeah. Now, if it's not perfect, we can go back in and keep ripping. Now, sometimes kids start to cut, and it starts to get ripped so tiny, we could always overlap scraps on top of one another, couldn't we? Keep going, keep going. We could if we needed to. All right.
So I just teared it like that.
Great.
And then I'm going to... mine's going to be kind of like a square mouse. Like, this will be the head.
That'll be the head. All right. So we're going to go ahead. Okay, get our glue out now.
Actually, this side is better, so I'm going to glue on this side.
Sounds good. We're going to open it
up. Dot, dot, not a lot.
Dot, dot, not a lot. And here it is. We'll check. Is our patient breathing? Uh-oh.
Mommy, can you help?
Oh, gosh. You want me to pick the nose?
Yeah.
So we pick the nose usually. We turn, and then we see if the patient is breathing. And indeed.
Should I do one?
My patient is breathing,
two,
too.
Three, four. And then
dot, not a lot. And then just off to the side and put it right in the middle. Now, the next step, oh gosh, we even forgot that really important thing.
Yes.
And put our name in the corner. Okay, and my lovely assistant, she brought her own pencil because that's the way we roll. Okay, so we've done this with gray paper before. We've also done it with brown paper, but it's creating the ears. Now, that first part that we saw right there, that was just really trying to rip and use that really, do what you want to here. Let's do some ears, some really big ears.
I'm doing big ones.
Me too. So some kiddos are really good right away with using some of those scissor skills, right? Walk, we can with them safely in the classroom.
How do we glue it?
How do we glue it?
Or do we use tape?
No, what should we use? What do you think? Regular old big glue. So on the shape, hang on. Yeah, that's it. On the shape, we'll do...
Oh, back.
Dot, dot, not a lot.
One.
And put it on there.
Two, three, four, five.
Dot, dot, not a lot. Now, we're using this kind of glue, regular school glue, because it glues the best. Glue sticks, they're nice, but they sometimes discolor paper.
Oopsies.
And we don't like that. So if we get a little bit, can we just put it on a rag off to the side? A little tissue? Yeah, totally. Now, for the legs, the arms, a lot of those. Nice job. That was it, Lucy. Just use another piece of paper to wipe off the extra glue. I'm just cutting
Or a
scrap, good one. I'm just cutting out little skinny strips of paper. Start to create arms.
Mommy,
do up or down.
Mrs. DeVilia says, always bigger, never smaller.
Oh, I love it.
Because if you make it smaller, you can't make it bigger. If you make it bigger, you can make it smaller.
You got it. I totally love that. Gems from the classroom teacher. Always shout out. Okay, love it. Okay, just do a few little dots. Now, I might put one of my legs in the front to make it look like it's... Oh, hello, I'm walking this direction. Oh, hello. Now, the few other parts that we put on here, pretty basic parts. This little guy, Frederick, the beautiful part about the story is that... Actually, I might have it look like it's kind of going up a little bit. Okay, so we've got the body, we've got the ears, we've got the arms,
legs. Can you wait for me?
You bet. You've got yours right there. Now, again, some kids are really, really good at starting to create multiple shapes. Some might start to fold it over. Now, again, some kiddos really like to have the shape drawn. So if that works for you, you go ahead and do that. Some kids like to cut them out individually, so I could draw two of them. So my assistant here is doing a fantastic job. So we're gonna use those for the eyes. These for the inside of the ears if you want. If you wanna make it look just a little bit more stylized for you, go for it. But the beautiful part about this lesson also is that we're learning the difference between geometric, shapes that are the same on both sides, symmetrical, and those that are asymmetrical. So if I folded that shape, it would not be the same on both sides. So once you've got the arms and the legs, the ears, I'm gonna make mine a little bit bigger actually. I've got my two little eyes.
Mommy, is that okay?
That looks fantastic. I love it. Close together, far apart, his head twisted. Okay, so it's fun to kind of play with placement right before you glue things down. Okay, and before I even start to glue them down, I'm gonna give this guy some little eyes, and I'm just using my regular pencil.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna do regular pencil, that'll do it, yeah?
Yeah. I'm doing the eyes.
Ooh, right on. Okay, I'm gonna get my little nose.
I like doing it folded and then, because then you can make, ooh!
Ooh, those look great!
They're not circles.
Yeah, they're not circles.
That's okay.
That's okay.
The whole point is to have fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So again, part of this is cutting with scissors. Get those straight edges. Some of them are using the pincher method. But one of the last types, I'm using one of these little slick sticks. My cute, little cute guy. Okay, you could also use a construction paper crayon. You could use a colored pencil. Lots of different things. White acrylic marker, if you're one of those fancy fancies that have some of these acrylic markers, that would work too. So this lesson lasts usually about a good 45 minutes, plus with the introduction and the reading of the story or anything related to this animal. So thank you for joining us. Any last words of wisdom about using glue?
Yes. It's okay to be messy. Because you get sticky fingers.
You do get sticky fingers.
Even though I don't have...
Let's get our hands moving.